As beautiful as this whole moment is, I just remember Amita crawling on this dirty floor that people have been walking on all day and taking this butterfly and just shoving it in my mouth and then
taking some of the dirt from the floor.
And I would just be like,
you were choking.
Stay in this.
Is this how you felt? And the poison killed you?
Yeah, he's dying.
If you weren't Grisha, you would still be alive.
If I hadn't drawn the poison from her small body into my own, she would have died.
Oh, God, she's...
This is how you know the show's good. It's just, just quiet.
I know, I'm trying to think of things to say.
She was so brilliant.
You were angry with me. Maybe you still are. And it's okay to feel that way.
So like that thing of having like a parent and then not having them.
What we do while we're alive.
So you went from this flashback to waking up to stuffing a butterfly.
Yeah, that's literally what that was. Yeah.
That is all we can control.
It's the first contract. This is the first time we really get to see this vulnerability from Jasper. I think.
Yeah.
It was fun trying to figure out like the different, because it was a dream version of Kaz, and trying to like play something slightly different.
How did it feel for you to kind of?
Weird.
Yeah.
Spend like 2 seasons building up this guy who can't even take his gloves off, and then suddenly all of this is happening.
And it's not even real.
And it's not real.
Yes.
No. I remember being so like,
this isn't real. This is
heartbroken when she realizes it's not real.
Because that's the turning point, isn't it? That's when everyone starts realizing and gets pulled out.
Boom! Right.
They had these apples rigged to explode. Because obviously we can't just shoot apples at
somebody. Really? This.
Yeah. So they were rigged to explode.
But you did that one.
I did the one with the spin. Yeah,
quite.
I had an excellent teacher.
Yeah, you were such a natural with everything I was teaching
the
you.
The costumes are fantastic, aren't they?
Yeah, I love the colours.
I remember when we had a read-through of this script.
Oh, yeah.
I remember that too.
And just, I was like, oh, this is going to be very good.
People were crying, weren't they?
Yeah, I was. I had to voice note you afterwards to be like, that was good.
Yeah, you risk your life for your friends.
I really do love the arc that Jesper goes through in this.
Yeah, it's such a personal journey. I just happen to look fantastic while being an excellent show. Butterfly time.
These butterflies were made specifically for us to...
It was black marzipan.
It was marzipan, that's
And the
right.
wings were really sharp, and they tasted awful.
They were terrible.
But they had blue dye on them, so any time we put one in our mouths, it was like a 5-minute reset of wet wipes and stuff. And yeah, and they tasted disgusting.
Oh, Alan. We need 3 more.
Okay.
Friends of the Hell Show, lay down your money and prepare your nerves.
He's so great.
Dean's so good on the day.
Love Dean.
Waited all day to do this.
Yeah, the whole day.
There all day.
Yeah. Last
week. I give you something special. Of conviction and rage.
Rage.
That sound too.
Yeah, so good.
Enter.
I love how they left it down a little so your head had to dip to get through, to make you look even taller. Yeah.
No. Matthias! Matthias!
Oh, I hate the sound of my own voice.
No.
Sometimes I really do. So I think I've solved it here. I'm like, I got it.
Yeah. It's quite loud in there, right? So you're not going to be... Yeah. No one's going to hear you.
Alva has been pardoned. You must stop this immediately.
We're hopeful there.
Yeah, so hopeful. hope, the biggest evil of them all. Yet.
There's no stopping this.
Oh. You what?
Please, please, take me to who's in charge. Take me to who's in charge.
Enough of that. Back off, people.
Yeah, and obviously, like, she knows so much about Fjordan culture that to see you fight wolves is, like, painful for her as well.
Right. And there's nothing worse that could have came out of that gate than this. I would rather fought the dragon lizard.
Yeah.
I did a lot of training with these wolves as well.
I was just going to say, like, you actually spent so much time with them, fed them and everything.
Yeah. I feel like we actually had
a connection.
Your
abs are sick.
On the day when we filmed it, it had to be very quiet for these snarls and around the wolves.
Yeah,
in general.
The energy was actually mad in
very
that
intense,
day.
Yeah.
Like the cave in itself had such ambience atmosphere anyway, and then bringing in these guys and everyone miming.
They're big.
Because like if they got a trigger, like.
Mm-hmm. Look at them.
Oh, they were so beautiful. I remember they were so beautiful.
And these stunt guys are so great too.
Do you remember what they're doing? They were just like. Putting meat in front of them, weren't they? And I love. Sorry, I haven't got there yet.
The timing of it.
No, the bit where you go, "Gel will absolve me" or something. Yeah, is it here? Yeah. Wait.
Score.
I think what's big about that is that. Yeah. So good. Vibes. But I think what's big about that moment is that like. I've come to save you, but now because you've killed someone in front of everyone, there's nothing I can do.
Yeah.
I can get you a pardon for being a slaver, but I can't. There's nothing I can, now you've killed a guard, there's no way to get you out. So it's like, I don't know what else I can do.
It's all messed up, it's all
just slipping
away. He knows
it away.
Too.
Yeah, he's delighted.
Yeah, he loves
it. Delira with his Stoira.
These guys were very, very great to work with, super intense.
I think I improvised those lines. Oh, but those guys were great, yeah.
Yeah. Love this. It's very sad.
It's very sad.
That realization is different than the first one.
Yeah, 100%.